all times. His praises shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Do me a favor. Magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Our God truly is greater than anything you could ever face. Let's make our boast in him this morning. Come on, put those hands together.
So good. give God the glory. Father, we love you. We bless you. We thank you that everything that we have need in your hands have always provided. You are everything.
Yes, you are. Praise God, everybody. This is Pastor Show. Did you enjoy praise and worship? I know I always enjoy praise and worship. Matter of fact, I just want Have Life to know. Everybody that's watching, you all need to know Have Life Church is just spoiled. We have the best music staff. We have the best arts staff. We have the best singers you can find. Listen, every single time they pick up the mic, pick up their instruments, get their flags to dance, the entire atmosphere shifts. I thank God that they are so powerful that it comes right into your living room. Right now, wherever you are to be grateful that we have such an incredible music and arts ministry. We can't wait to get back to the building so that we can see Miss Aaliyah Longmire and all the dancers giving God praise and waving their flags, because I'm excited about the union of the body. But listen, we praise through praise and worship, and we should. But now let's turn to the Word of God. I'm starting a new series. We were in an old series last month where we followed our pastor, Dr. R.A. Vernon, the Word Church, Cleveland, Ohio. I always want to honor him and honor his voice. He led the Shepherd's Connection into a series about staying in the house, and we honored that series. And I believe the Lord moved, and even last week, co-pastor, she delivered a dynamic message for the body of Christ, and we thank God for her. But I want to switch gears. And I want to deal with a new series. Here's what I'm calling it: The Domino Effect. The Domino Effect. This new series, The Domino Effect. Here's the thematic thrust that I want to give all of Have Life and all of our friends, everyone watching across the city, the nation, and even the world. I believe, watch this, everything in your life is about to fall into place. My God, do you feel that? Have you been praying? Matter of fact, let me prophesy to each and every one of you that's watching this. Maybe you're watching this live, or you're watching it later. Maybe your friend sent it to you and shared it with you. Let me point my finger right in your face and prophesy to you that in the name of Jesus, by the power of the Holy Spirit, that everything in your life is about to fall into place. Now, do you receive that? If you receive that, I want you to give God some praise. I want you to honor him right now. I want you to bless his name. Matter of fact, you want to stand up on your feet wherever you are and lift your hands and begin to thank God that everything in your life is about to fall into place. That's good, everybody. Let's go to James chapter 1. It's going to be on the screen for you. And then we're going to look at 1 Thessalonians 5. James chapter 1. And then 1 Thessalonians 5. Let me hurry to the text. I want to make sure I use my time wisely. James chapter 1. This is the God's Words translation. I'm going to read verses 2, 3, and 4. It starts off like this. My brothers and sisters, be very happy. Some versions say, count it all joy. Be very happy when you are tested in different ways. Be very happy when you are tested in different ways. Watch this, verse 3. You know that such testings of your faith produces endurance. Verse 4, endure, watch this, until your testing is over. Wow. Endure, verse 4, let's stay there. Endure until your testing is over. Then you will be mature and complete, and you won't need anything. I need you to point to somebody in the room and say, if you keep on holding on, you won't need anything later. Come on, point to somebody right there in the room with you. If you by yourself, point right back at me. If you hold on, you won't need anything in the end. Okay. I haven't even gotten to my second verse, and I feel like preaching my second text, and I feel the Holy Ghost. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. This is real short. This is quick. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 17, verse 16, and then verse 17. Verse 16 says, rejoice always. Verse 17 says, pray without ceasing. Albert Schweitzer, famed theologian, writer, and Nobel Peace Prize winner, said these words, and I quote, eventually, all things fall into place. Until then, laugh at the confusion. Until then, live for the moments. And know everything happens for a reason. If you're not too mean, I need you to help me in the text, in the chat right now. I need you to help me let everybody know what my subject is. Here's my subject this morning, Have Life, until it turns. until it turns. Type that in the chat. Tell somebody you're watching with until it turns. This message is to help the believer recognize two critical things. First, we ought to believe that everything will fall into place when we are in the will of God. And then second, that our first response in any situation is critical in that process and procedures follow our first response. There are moments in our lives when first impressions stick and you can't get them out your mind. I don't know if you've ever dealt with someone responding to your excitement with a lull, but that lull sticks with you even though they try to fake excited later. Okay, let's make it personal. When a wife comes to a husband and says, "I'm pregnant," he has one shot to be happy. Listen to me, he has one opportunity to be happy. He can't say anything like, "Is it mine?" No, you can't say that. He can't say anything like, "Are you sure?" Or "Oh man." No. The very first response has to be excitement and joy and hugging and loving on you, letting you know he's absolutely into this baby being born. He gets one. Okay, so after he makes the mistake and doesn't respond right, he may say, "Oh no, I'm happy." But for some reason, that first response, that initial reaction sets precedence in her heart. And I believe that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as we're going through this series, I believe that God's going to give us a fresh look at how we reacted to pain and turn that thing around and make a new precedence in our life. I believe the purpose of this leadoff message is to change that around, to change our faith system, to change our mind's position. Check this out, everybody. And then make sure that all the dominoes fall into place. I want you to do me a huge favor at the onslaught of this message. I think this is imperative, everybody, as we move forward. I want you to fill in the blank. You're going to fill in your blank, and then after you fill in your blank, you're going to add until it turns. Watch this. Stay with me. You're going to fill in the blank, and then after you fill in the blank, you're going to put until it turns. What do you mean, Pastor? I'm going to pray, and I'm going to keep on praying until it turns. I'm going to fast, and I'm going to keep on fasting until it turns. I'm going to be on my watch, making sure my family is right until it turns. I'm going to be in my Bible, reading my word until this thing turns. I'm going to keep on sowing until this thing turns. I'm going to keep evangelizing and trying to get my family saved until this thing turns. I'm going to keep being a good parent. I'm going to keep trying to honor my children, love my children, raise my children until this thing turns. I will not give up on my future because it's going to turn. I won't give up on my marriage because it's going to turn. I won't give up on my body being healed because it's going to turn. I won't give up on my career because it's going to turn. I won't throw in the towel. Why, Pastor Show? Because it's going to turn. I'm going to keep on doing everything God told me to do until this thing turns. I'm not sure how long it's going to take. That's what you really want me to talk about. But I'm going to be honest. I'm not sure how long this entire ordeal that you're going through is going to take. But I will say this. I'll stand my watch. Ooh, this is good. Have life. I hope you feel the presence of God where you are, like I feel him in my home. I'm going to stand my watch. Like Habakkuk chapter 2 says, God's word translation, I will stand my watch, or I will stand at my guard post. I will station myself on the wall. I will watch to see what he will say to me and what I will answer, or what how he will answer my complaint. Watch this. Where is this coming from, Habakkuk? Why are you talking to God like this? Because you seem to be upset, because you seem to be distraught. Where are these words generating from? This is the perfect moment for us to really deal with the complaint of Habakkuk. But you got to go back to Habakkuk chapter 1, verse 13. He says, God, your eyes are too pure to look at evil. You can't watch wickedness. Why do you keep watching treacherous people? Why are you silent? Why are you silent when wicked people swallow those who are more righteous than they are? Now, just like Habakkuk, you've had several weeks to complain. Stay with me, have life. It's going to get better. You've had several weeks to complain about staying at home. You've had several weeks to complain about certain things happening in your life. You've had several weeks to be down on yourself and you're saying, how long am I going to have to deal with this? I don't know. But let me tell you what the Bible is telling us through Habakkuk. I need you to stand your watch. I need you to stay on the wailing wall. I need you to keep praying. I need you to keep believing. I need you to stay in your word. I need you to remember those scriptures I gave you several weeks ago. I need you to get on that prayer call and pray with us. I need you to be in groups and hear a taught word. I need you to stay in your lane and align yourself with the will of God. How long, Pastor Show? Until it turns. Woo, this is good. This is good. Until this thing turns, until your enemies become your footstool. I need you to stay until your body starts to feel better, until peace begins to flow through your house, until the glory of God comes back over you. I need you to stand your watch. I need you to keep going. How long, Pastor Show? Until it turns. There is, whether you recognize it or not, an appointed time for all things to end. There is an appointed time for your pain to end. There's an appointed time for your frustration to end. There's an appointed time where things will begin to fall in line. The domino effect, things start to fall in line. James chapter 1, I haven't forgotten my opening scripture. My brothers and sisters, be very happy or count it all joy when you are tested in different ways. Right? You know, such testing is producing. The testing is producing endurance. This is important. Verse 4, endure until the testing is over. I know you might not want to hear that. Those of you who see, you think I'm just talking about Corona. No. I'm not even talking about Corona. I'm talking about what's going on in your house. I'm talking about what's going on in your body, what's going on in your mind, what's going on in your finances, what's happening with your career. There are people that are watching me now that are being tested in their job area, in their career area, in their banking and finance area, in where they're going to live, in real estate. There are people being tested, or not being sick with Corona, but allergies or whatever the case may be. There are people that are being tested in their parenting. You're waiting for a child to start acting right and waiting for the spirit of rebellion to leave your house. I don't know where this test comes from. Come on, we're not going to have a truncated, myopic understanding that Corona is the only thing going on in the world. No, there are people right now that are going through in their marriage. There are people right now that are dealing with depression and rejection and loneliness, and I need you to fight. How long? Fight until it turns. Oh, this is good. This is good. Have life. This is good. This is good. Listen. Let me slow down. I want to make sure I give you this word, and I want this word to seep into your heart. Between the start and the finish, there is a middle part. Wow. I need everybody to stay engaged, stay engaged. But between the beginning of it and the ending of it, there is a middle part that we don't normally see coming. Ooh, Pastor, talk about that. Yeah. There's a middle part that nobody wants to preach about. In the middle part, see, in the middle part is where we have instructions that we don't want to obey. But I'm here to tell you, in the middle part, the Lord will release instructions that are vital to you finishing your course. There are instructions that are important for you getting out. There are instructions that are critical to you surviving the mess you're in, and they're located in the middle. I need every believer watching me and everybody that's still not sure whether they want to give their life to Jesus. You just stumbled upon this broadcast. I need everybody to understand God does not leave you in the middle. No, he is there with you in the middle. But when you're in the middle of a crisis, when you're in the middle of some pain, when you're in the middle of everything seeming like it's going to fall apart, when you're in the middle of everybody being against you, when you're in the middle of depression, in the middle of rejection, in the middle of sadness, in the middle of uncertainty, that's where your obedience is required the most. Oh God, this is good. Are you hearing me preach this good? Right in the middle is where your obedience is required the most, because in the middle, everybody, watch this, that's where the war takes place. See, when you start off, there's not a war when you start off. There's not a war when you're crossing the finish line. The war takes place right in that middle section. In that middle section is when you need to exercise faith. In that middle section, when it seems like all hope is lost, you decide, I'm going to stand my watch until this thing is over, until God delivers me, until God brings me through it. Listen, Paul was writing to the church at Thessalonica. He was writing words of encouragement. Come on, Pastor Show, give it to him. Here it is. He was writing words of encouragement. It was to make sure that the believers knew they weren't alone. I know you're saved. I know you're filled with the Holy Spirit. I know you love communion. I know you've been baptized multiple times until it's stuck. I know you like getting your feet washed. I know all those things. You like convention and church. Yeah. But every now and then, even the most sanctified people need a fresh word from the Lord. Even the most dedicated people need a fresh word of encouragement. Here's what I want to give you. I want to give you some encouragement that you have the strength to make it to see this thing to the end. You're going to be able to have the strength to stay until it turns. You're going to have the mind, the wherewithal to stay your course until. Paul was sending a message of encouragement to the church. Watch this, everybody. Paul says to them, I'm sending this word to you. Watch this. So you don't turn to idols. This is good, everybody. He said, I'm encouraging you to make sure you don't turn to false teachers that sound good, but it's not according to wisdom. He said, I'm sending you this encouraging word so you don't turn to the mess you came out of or that God delivered you or picked you up out of. I'm sending you this message so you don't turn back to your old ways. I'm sending you this message because I want to make sure you walk in wisdom and integrity. But here's the best part of what Paul was saying. Even though you have questions, I love this part the most. He says to the church, he says, even though you have questions, even though you have uncertainty, stick with what I already taught you. My God, that preaches all by itself. He says to the church, I'm not with you now, but when I was there, I taught you. And I left elders there to teach you. I left deacons there to run revivals and teach you. Here's what Paul is trying to get them to understand. You're not going to get all the answers. You're not going to understand why everything happened. You're not going to understand why you have to go through what you have to go through. He says, but until your answers come, if they ever come, stick with what I already taught you. The word you've already received, stick with that. The prayers we've already prayed, stick with that. Stay with that until the answers become clear or till God touches your heart to be okay with where he has you. This is a good word for the house. Did you hear what I said? He's saying, keep with the kingdom standards until this thing turns. Funny thing, everybody, Paul, most people don't even recognize this, but right after he tells them to stay their course and don't turn to idols and don't go back to your old ways and don't go back to the things that you got delivered from, he tells them something specific that blew my mind. He says, and don't forget your breastplate. See, the church at Ephesus was not the only church he dealt with the whole armor of God. He says, I want you all to put on the breastplate. I want you all to put on your helmet. The church at Ephesus, he gave a longer list of a soldier's uniform. But to this church in Thessalonica, he gives them just two parts. He says, based on what you need, he says, I'm going to give you the breastplate. And I want you to put that on. Check this out, everybody. He tells them the breastplate of faith and love. The breastplate of faith and love. And then he gives them the second part, the helmet of hope in salvation. This is good, everybody. I need you to keep your fire of faith. I need you to exercise love and keep your hope in God. Keep your hope. Matter of fact, help me right there in the chat. Why don't you encourage somebody and tell them, keep your hope in God. Please do that for me. Do it for me right now. Tell somebody in the chat, I need you all to keep your hope in God. Everyone working in security, come on, drop that security emoji. Tell everybody, keep your hope, keep your faith in God. I need everyone that works facilities, everyone that works in hugs and security, I need you to drop your emoji and tell everybody else, keep your faith, keep your hope, keep your love. This is good. This is good, everybody. I need, this is pivotal. I need everyone to hear me Whatever you feel, whatever you're thinking about, whatever you hear, it requires, watch this, a response. It requires a response. We don't want to react. We want to respond. Listen to that. We don't want to react. That happens in the flesh. Those reactions happen in the flesh. We want to exercise wisdom and integrity, and we want to respond. You have to respond right, because your first response sets the pattern for everything that falls behind it. We want everything to fall in line according to the will of God. We want everything to fall in line according to what God has spoken in our spirits, like the domino effect. But that first response is critical. I'm asking God, give us an opportunity to go back and respond first again. God, would you do that for us? Would you give us the opportunity to go back and respond the first time like we did the last time? No, Pastor, will I ever really get that back? Listen, we have to have a change of heart. We got to go back to that first initial response and cancel that in Jesus' name, and now respond with the blood, and now respond with the word, and now respond with praise, and now respond with integrity. Why? Because the domino effect says once you start off right, everything else, once you start off in the will of God, everything else, once you start off in integrity, everything else, once you start off doing what God asks us to do, everything else will fall in line. This is good, everybody. It's important that you hear these next three statements before I'm out of your face, before I'm gone, before we close this broadcast. This is imperative. Have life. I need you to check this out. I need you to stay with me. James chapter 1, 2 through 4 is telling us to count it all joy or be happy. Have joy or be happy. Have joy or be happy. I don't care what you're dealing with right now. You've got to fight for your joy. Listen to your pastor. You've got to fight for your joy. You've got to fight for your smile. Do not let what you're dealing with take away your smile. Don't let what you're dealing with take away your joy. Fight for your joy. Get your smile back. Raise your countenance. Allow God to give you a fresh perspective. No, it doesn't matter what you're dealing with. That thing can't control you anymore. It doesn't matter what the phobia is. It can't control you anymore. It doesn't matter what the fear is. It doesn't matter the anxiety. It doesn't matter the pain. It can't control you anymore. It doesn't matter who doesn't like you, who rejected you, why you're depressed, who's being mean to you, who said no to you. We're counting it all joy. We're going to get our smile back. We're going to get our joy back, and we're going to fight to maintain it. Count it all joy. That's number one. Here's number two, everybody. Here's number two, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. It says this, verse 16 and 17. It says, rejoice always and pray without ceasing. Listen, make time to praise. Matter of fact, we in church right now. Have you lifted your hands since we've been in church? Have you said thank you, Jesus, or hallelujah? Matter of fact, would you take just 30 seconds and lift up a praise to God? Father, we thank you. We take time to bless you. We take time to honor you. We take time to lift our voices and tell you how good you've been. You've kept us. You've loved us. You've fed us. You've protected us. You've been there for us. Even when we didn't see your hand, we trust your heart. God, we love you. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord Most High. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for being good to us. Have you really offered God a sincere praise? Have you gotten up off the couch anytime during this service and really offered God the worship that's due his name? We need to find time, make time to praise and pray. This is the second one, everybody. You got to make time to pray. You have to listen. I know it may be uncomfortable even in your living room praising, but that is what God requires of us. It may be difficult with your schedule being crazy to carve out that time to pray, but that's what God is requiring of us. Our prayer time needs to get a boost from heaven right now, and I'm encouraging everybody to pray and praise. Here's the third one, everyone, and I'm out of your face. Fight for what you love until it turns. Rebecca said, I'm going to stand my watch. I'm going to stay right here until God speaks. I want you to fight. If you love it, if you hold it dear, I want you to fight. And you're not fighting by yourself, because everyone that's watching right now, we're fighting with you. We're fighting together. We're joining our faith together, believing God's going to hear and answer prayer. We're believing God for something miraculous. I want you to fight until it turns. I want you to hold. Hold on. Matter of fact, I speak strength into you right now. And lift your hands right where you are. I don't care what you're doing. Lift your hands right now in the name of the Lord Jesus. I speak a fresh fight in you. I speak the strength of the Lord Jesus Christ and the power of the Holy Spirit to strengthen you in the innermost man now, so that you can fight and you can hold on until this thing breaks, until it turns, until it's different, until it changes. There's a breaking the Lord's releasing right now into your house. There's a breaking the Lord is releasing into your spirit right now. There's a strength being added with your name on it. There's a power being added to you. It has your name on it. And you're going to fight this thing until it turns. My resolve have life is to trust God until it turns. And then guess what? After it turns, I'm still going to trust God. After it turns, I'm going to give God praise. After it turns, I'm going to keep praying. After it turns, I'm not going to abandon what I did to get here. That's what many of us do wrong. We do what it takes to get what we want from God, and then we abandon the God that gave it to us. No, we're setting a new precedence, a new procedure, a new track record, so all of these dominoes keep falling in line and our lives keep falling into place. Do you hear what I'm saying? I want you to hold on to God until your children change. I want you to hold on to God until your marriage changes. I want you to hold on to God until your purpose is clear. I want you to hold on to God until he speaks to you about marriage, whether you're supposed to be married or not. I want you to hold on to God until he tells you and gives you the direction you need for your life. Hold on to God. How long, Pastor Show? Until it turns. Listen, I want to pray for you. I believe God's about to do something great in your life. I want to pray for you. I need everybody to give me your attention. Don't tune me out now. I want to speak over your life. I believe that this word is powerful. I believe that this word came straight from heaven. Matter of fact, listen to me. I believe this entire series, God's going to move in a mighty way. Every single message of this entire series called The Domino Effect. And I want to pray for you. But listen, if there's anybody that needs a church, man, I would love to be your virtual pastor. Never thought I'd say that. I never knew this would actually be a thing, but I would love to be your virtual pastor. You can join Have Life on this virtual platform. All you have to do is text us and let us know you want to join. We want to correspond with you. We want to get back to you. We want to let you know that we love you. Matter of fact, not just joining the church, but maybe you want to join the body of Christ. Maybe you are far from God. Don't turn me off. I want to pray for everybody, but let me just address everyone corporately. Maybe you've never asked the Lord Jesus Christ to be your Savior. Maybe you've never asked the Lord Jesus Christ to be your Lord. This is your moment. Okay, Pastor Show, I went to church with my grandmother, or I was connected to God, but you know, life happened. Pastor, come on. Life happened to me, and I don't know where the disconnect was. Okay, I'm talking to you, bro. I'm talking to you, sis. Listen, right where you are, it's time for you to come back. It's time for you to come back to the fold. It's time for you to make a decision. I want you to text to get saved. I want you to make a decision to text to get saved. I want to correspond with you. I want to make sure that we lead you to the Lord properly. We want to make sure we throw our arms around you, and virtually, of course, and love you and make sure you have a family to live saved with. So some of you are texting to join right now. Some of you are texting to give your life to Jesus right now. The rest of you are about to text to give. Thank you for your gifts. Wow, you have done a great job blessing the house of God. But nothing has changed. We're not in the house yet. There are people still struggling in their finances, and we're praying for them. Listen, I'm not saying this for fluff. I pray for you. Co-pastor prays for you. Our intercessors, we're praying for you. Our leaders, our elders, we're praying for you. We're calling your name. We're believing God that he's going to turn it around, but we're going to stay the course. So here's what I need us to do, Have Life. And I'm getting ready to pray. Don't turn me off. I'm getting ready to pray. Have Life. Listen, I want you to tithe, but then I want you to do more than your tithe. Again, we're not in the building, so I was just asking for tithe plus 20. But everyone, listen to me, under the sound of my voice, whether you are a member of Have Life or not, even if you're just peeking in from a peripheral, I need you to sow at least a $40 seed. Yes, right now. Use that money that you were going out with. Use that movie money. Use that salon money. Use whatever. Matter of fact, you should be saving a lot of money staying in the house. Here's what I want you to do. I want each and every one of you that still receives a check. Here's what I need you to do. If you have increase in your life, any level of increase, you tithe from that. You tithe from increase. No matter what it is, if it's increase, you tithe. And I need everyone to sow an additional $40. Let's help make up the difference for those who cannot. Those who cannot, man, I love you. When you had a means to sow, you did so. You gave and you honored the house. So I'm not directing anything towards you but love and peace and understanding and prayer. But everyone else, here's what I need you to do. I need you to sow. You're getting ready to do that. Let me pray now. Let me pray now. Let me pray now. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I love you and I thank you, God, for sending this word and allowing me the opportunity to minister the words of life. Father, in Jesus' name, everyone that's watching me live right now and everyone that will watch this later, I'm asking in Jesus' name that you visit them and visit them with strength. Let the power of the living God drench them. Let the glory of God overshadow them and give them strength. Your strength, if we let it, God, can be made perfect right when we're in our weakness, right at our point of stress and pain. And I'm asking in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ that you strengthen every viewer now, from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. Whatever they're dealing with, give them the strength to hold on. Whatever they're encountering, give them the power to stay the kingdom course until it turns. God, let everything begin to fall back into place. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Listen, I love you. I thank God for you. I appreciate you. You're about to sign off right now and text to give. Some are texting to join. Some are texting to get saved. I love you. I appreciate you. Can't wait to see you next time.
Have Life, Your Spiritual Growth Matters. Groups are back in full swing, but we're virtually now. We want to see you there. Gain a greater biblical revelation and fellowship with your peers at Have Life Church. You can sign up today at havelife.net/groups. Married and engaged couples, this means with a ring, Have Life wants to see your artistic skills. Join our For Life Marriage Ministry on Friday, May 22nd for virtual couples paint night. It's $40 per couple, but you have to register. havelife.net/forlife by May 15th to secure your spot. Do you work on the front lines as an essential worker? We want to know. Email us at info@havelife.net and let us know you're serving our community during this pandemic. Mother's Day is coming this weekend. There are so many ways that you can celebrate your mother. If you would like to send a 1 to 2 minute video with your mom, or tell us a funny story about your mom, then tag @HaveLifeChurch, #HaveLifeFunny. These are your announcements for this week. Remember to give life. We love you.